Hello and welcome to another screencast from kalalog.com. In this tutorial we will look at how to do a digital painting of a glass of ale. The end result would look something like this. I will provide this palette as a GIMP save file for download. Now if you are watching this video elsewhere, like at YouTube, then visit kalalog.com and search for it. Let us start. I am using GIMP version 2.6. You should be able to get similar results in other software like Photoshop. Now you will see here I have set up 3 layers. You can ignore the overlay and the palette. First let us set up the background. We will set up the glass of ale on a wooden table. So what I do is I use the color picker and select this color, then switch to my background and fill it with that. You'll see this palette over the background, but that is fine, we'll be turning it off later. Next, select the color of the table, a wooden table, and the lower half. Or the lower third, I'll fill it with that color. I could leave the background as such, but I like to have a distinct line between the table and the background. Okay, now we are ready. Switch to the line layer and use the path editor or the path tool. Draw somewhat a rectangle. For the last point, I hold down the control and then close the polygon. Instead of a rectangle, let us give it a bit of an interesting shape. Then what I do is I curve this upwards. The bottom part, I curve it downwards. So now we have the shape of a glass. Select the black color and on the line, I stroke it with width of 3. Then what I do is I draw a new path, I select some other tool and then go back to the path tool. And then I will be marking out a closed polygon which is having just 2 nodes. Now this is a closed polygon having 3 nodes. Instead what you do is click on the first node, then the second node, hold down the control and then click on the first node back again. Okay. 1, 2, control, click on the first one. adjust the curve. Once you're satisfied, we'll stroke it with, let us say, a 2 or a 1, 1.5 perhaps. Okay, we have our line art ready. What you do is go back to the path section and ignore this one. So go back to the path section and select the previous path. Then what you have to do is convert this path to a selection. I will be painting on the paint layer. I take the paint brush. I make sure that since I am using a Wacom tablet, I do not want a pressure sensitivity on the opacity. So I make sure it is not ticked. The size is fine. And then I take somewhat of the mid-tone color and can paint it. I might as well fill it for now. Actually, before that, we need to make sure that we render the glass properly. So before we take that color, we'll take this particular color, the one that reflects and refracts the ambient color, because it's going to be a stout glass. The glass is going to have some thickness to it. Now what I'll do is, now I would take the paintbrush, select this color, make sure I do not have opacity, I'm going to leave bottom section. I'm not going to fill it, because usually glasses are stout at the bottom. In the top section, ale will usually have froth on top of it, so roughly leave that much of it off. Fill it up and clean it. Don't worry if it looks odd. Next we'll take the froth mid-tone color. Paint this part. This curve should follow the curve you have above here. Once you're satisfied with that, let me zoom in a bit. going to be roughly the same thickness. Now we are going to decide on where the light direction is going to be from. So I'm going to assume it's the light direction is somewhere from this direction. So what that's going to do is it's going to cache the highlights in this area, and it's going to cache the shadows in this area. Also, what is going to happen is the light here, the shadow here is going to get reflected here. And the shadow is going to be more darker on this edge here. That is because this is towards us and this is being obstructed by the liquid there. So let's start rendering. The paint tool. So this is the lighter shadow that I'll use. Zoom in a bit. Okay. Now that's also going to be the bottom segment here. That's going to be darker because we have a wooden table underneath. That's going to show up something like this. Try to retain the form of the glass. I mean, if you had drawn the glass as a parallel cylindrical glass, then these would be just straight vertical lines. Let's just finish off with the shadows. Now this shadow is going to be reflected here on this side. As I mentioned earlier, the highlight or the lighter color would also be here. Now before we go there, the darker part of the shadow, something like this. next what I'm going to do, so I'm going to put the lighter tone. Let's start working on the froth. So take the darker tone and render it here. Now the froth is not going to be as transparent as the liquid, so we wouldn't see that amount of, you know, the shadow reflection taking place here. So what we'll do is we'll just render it as a simple cylinder here. Since the light is coming from this direction, and the glass will have more shadow on this area. Now this is the highlight being reflected on the back of the glass. We have a highlight section here, so I wanted to depict that being reflected, but since it is through the glass, it won't be as bright. Sort of, you know, bring it the same tone as the sky. Froth highlight. Okay, now we'll render the glass itself a bit. this dark tone has been just the base, so the table would get refracted through the glass, the color of the table. So I choose that color. Let me zoom in a bit here. Of the brush, here what's going to happen is the background color is going to be refracted. So let me just color it at this point, this horizontal point. Choose this color. Now we'll give some really bright highlights, somewhat of a white, not totally white. Okay, that should do. Reflection here and on the opposite side. And there you have it, a glass of air. You can give some background to give it a bit of depth. To do is you select the background color, push it a bit darker, now you have a digital painting of a glass of ale. Hope you like this tutorial. Please do post your questions, suggestions, and comments below. Thank you.